Quite a nice view, wasn't it, from the North Shore Event Centre, looking over downtown Auckland. And that's where we are for this New Zealand Open, the Skycity New Zealand Badminton Open. And we've had one final down, four to go. We know the mixed doubles has gone to the teenagers of Zhang and Chen. Is another teenager about to win the next? Well, the answer is yes, because we got two of them in the women's singles final.
Welcome to the introduction for the women's singles final here at the Skycity New Zealand Badminton Open 2015. Your umpire from Australia, David Turner. Your service judge from New Zealand, Sydney Galos. Introducing your players in the women's singles final, would you please welcome from China, Hui Bing Zhao.
And what a talent this young girl seems to be. We've just
and
been talking
from Japan,
about
Saena Kawakami.
Yeah, you feel like it's going to be a tough proposition for Kawakami, who really upset the odds a little bit yesterday in her semi-final win against Cheung of Hong Kong. If He Bing Zhao plays anything like we saw her play yesterday, Oliver, I mean, listen, I've not seen Kawakami in action, to be fair, but it's hard to see anyone stopping her, particularly at this level. She won a couple of weeks ago. She's confidence is sky high. Would it be as one-sided, you think, as maybe what we saw in the mixed doubles?
Well, for Kawakami's sake, hopefully not. But yeah, yesterday, He Bing Zhao was just a class above. Ahori from Japan, she made it look easy. She was in control, the whole match. And it'll be interesting to see if Kawakami can do anything different. Maybe she's learned from watching the match yesterday, where maybe she can score some points, particularly in that forehand corner on the front court of He Bing Zhao, but it's not going to be easy.
Well, Kawakami is still playing junior badminton. Her last tournament was the German Juniors, where she made the semi-final. She's come to a senior tournament, she's come through qualifying, and she's made a final. She must feel like, in a way, she's won already.
Yeah, it's a phenomenal achievement for anybody to come through qualifying in a Grand Prix gold event and then find themselves still playing on Sunday.
This is the young lady that she has to be, and well, you can only be impressed if you've been watching He Bing Zhao. Asia junior champion, Olympic youth champion, world junior silver medalist. She comes with some pedigree. And look at that career win-loss ratio. This year, obviously, winner of the China Masters as well. Her second senior title, her first at Grand Prix gold level as well. Now on the verge of another here this afternoon. And this is how she's done it, all the way in straight games. And look, 41 minutes as long as she's been on court. And that's when she did take the match straight away. She had two match points before coming through against Nidera 22-20 in the second. It's a tough proposition, isn't it, for Saena Kawakami? Her world ranking gives you an idea. 610. Now, obviously, she's not played that many senior events, but still,
yeah,
she's here. She's in the final.
She's clearly miles better than 610 in the world. To make a Grand Prix gold final from qualifying in your first effort outside of Japan. But like you say, she's only 17. And to have like a 17 and 18-year-old in the final of a Grand Prix gold is crazy to see the depth of women's singles in world badminton at the moment.
Yeah, unbelievable. 17, 18-year-old won the gold in the last match. And here's how she got here. As you can see yesterday, coming through in three games in just over an hour. Straight games prior to that as well. She has won this year, actually. She won the Dutch junior event back in January. So, you've got to think she's going to be a little bit nervous ahead of this. A really big proposition ahead for her. Let's hear her thoughts then. She's been talking to Steve.
Saena, congratulations on making your first Grand Prix final. How are you feeling right now?
Well, this is the first time for myself to be in the final Grand Prix gold, but she feels like she's a challenger, so she's going to give her best shot.
We're sure she will. I mean, in a way, she's got nothing to lose, has she? Pressure's off here, off her. She's achieved more than probably what she expected to this week.
Yeah, absolutely. She's reached the final, like you said, coming from qualifying, and I'm sure she was extremely happy to win the semi last night. So maybe she's going to play with nothing to lose, or is she the type that's going to expect to just continue the good form and try and come out on top?
On my right, He Bing Zhao, China. On my left, Saena Kawakami, Japan. He Bing Zhao will serve, love all, play.
Well, the expectations in this women's singles is for another win here for China. But you have to say, Kawakami's upset the odds this week already a few times. Maybe she
serve
can do it again.
Over.
He Bing Zhao already trying to stamp some influence on them just wide, though, with that cross court.
Angles that she has from the back of the court.
Over, one, all.
We saw against Ohari yesterday, Ohari tried to exploit the front of the court, didn't she, against He Bing Zhao. There aren't many weaknesses though.
No, not at all.
Oh, she got to that one, Kawakami.
Service over.
Settled nicely,
two,
hasn't she?
One.
Hello.
That was well played.
She's not very demonstrative,
three,
is she? You know, 17-year-old first final Grand Prix gold level. There's no excitement in the face there, is it? And that's what you need, really.
Yeah, she's come out very focused and looks in control early on.
Great thing about being here at the venue, and obviously you get to stay in the hotel where the players are, you get to see them out and about. I've noticed Kawakami, you know, she's waiting for the bus this morning. You know,
four,
again,
one.
Very laid back, headphones on, just listening to some music. Last night I saw He Bing Zhao out having some ice cream and with some of her friends, you know, they're just taking their stride. Wow.
Exactly the start that Kawakami
five,
was after.
One.
Saw a little bit more aggression in that rally from He Bing Zhao, but came up with the error.
Well, it's great from a neutral perspective,
service,
isn't it, to see Kawakami start
two,
so well, settle
five,
into the match very quickly. Yeah, we want to see. We want to see some tension, we want to see some exciting badminton, don't we?
Yeah, the five semi-finals that we called yesterday were all pretty clear-cut winners, and the same in the mixed doubles this morning, so be good to get a bit more crowd involved as well. And you didn't see that from He Bing Zhao yesterday.
Yeah, no, everything was coming off the middle of the racket.
Six, two.
Maybe there's some nerves from her. As I said, that for Kawakami, nothing to lose. All the expectations, all the pressure really is on He Bing Zhao's shoulders, aren't they? Look at that, that's a delightful shot. Great wrist there.
Yeah, that's
seven,
what Ohari was able to do
two,
yesterday in patches, just bring He Bing Zhao from that around the head corner in the rear court on the diagonal to the forehand in the front. Too flat there from Kawakami, and He Bing Zhao was able to score the point with a smash winner down
three,
the line.
Seven.
was well wide from Irving Zhao, and the price is time for her, but
8-3.
She won't be best pleased with the way things have started here.
She just seems to be a little bit impatient.
Winning the point, but again, an encouraging rally really for Kawakami this, because she stuck around well, didn't she? And I see what you mean by impatience as well. There certainly is that from Irving Zhao.
9-4.
Yeah, Kawakami is certainly more skillful in a counter-attack type of game than Ohori was yesterday.
Through all the events that these girls
service
play, obviously I don't get to see
five,
Kawakami playing
nine.
In the junior badminton, and looking at, you know, the senior events, you know, the best she'd done is Osaka International on home soil. She made the last 16 this year. Obviously she's done well in junior tournaments, as you'd expect in the badminton that we're seeing. But here she is, 2-3 steps ahead of where she's been previously. Stung into action now, isn't she, Irving Zhao?
Service over, 6-10.
Yeah, she's come out the wrong side of the bed this morning. Maybe she didn't have that ice cream last night.
6-interval.
Irving Zhao up against it.
It's a different Irving Zhao that we've seen from yesterday so far. There's been plenty of unforced errors, easy mistakes, just like we've seen in that last point there. So I'm not sure what happened, if she's feeling a bit more pressure being in the final today. I don't know what it is.
Well, I watched her a couple of weeks ago in the final of the China Masters, and she played against He Shui, and it was over very, very quickly. She came out firing. Complete opposite to how she's come out today. But we have to give a lot of the credit as well, don't we, to her Japanese opponent at the other end.
Yeah, absolutely. She's given nothing away so far, and she's just been able to put a little more pressure on her than Ohori did in the semi-final yesterday. She just looks, maybe that's what's forcing the mistakes. She's a little bit earlier on the net and making Irving Zhao cover that extra step and a bigger court. Brilliantly worked rally from Kawakami there.
12-6.
I mean, the previous shot, she's got it right perfectly in the corner, and then the touch at the net, just spot on. Irving Zhao feels
13,
she needs to do something special to win a point.
It'll be interesting to see how she combats this. I mean, she hasn't really been tested so far this week, and she's been able to play her A game the whole time. Maybe she needs to come with a plan B today.
Oh, this is just... She's on the money today, Kawakami.
14,
I mean,
six.
This is an 8-point lead now she's got.
That's been an exquisite display of control so far from Kawakami, just really making Hibbing Jiao cover all four corners.
We'll have some of that back. But at the moment, Kawakami unflappable.
Service over. 7-14.
Another perfectly played point
service
from Kawakami.
15-7.
She's having to work so hard to get
service
every point.
8-15.
Yeah, she really is. It's been a step up from any of her other matches so far this week.
Which makes this a really tantalising prospect, this women's singles match. Now, Kawakami can maintain this level. Nothing to suggest, and this nerve start to get
service
on because
over 16,
there's no expectations for her coming into the final. But you suddenly get a lead like this, suddenly there is some expectation.
Yeah. Brilliant again. So quick to come forward and take it early on the net.
8.
That's just on the line.
Service over, 9-17.
No, that was a misjudgment. That was in.
Service over.
Terrific shot
18,
from Kawakami again.
9.
She's really mixing it up nicely.
Rare mistake.
Service over, 10, 18.
Jiao, but she's still unable to dominate.
11-18.
Yeah, both these players just playing with some sublime control. Everything is so close to the lines. Both playing really, really well. Yeah, inch perfect.
That's more like it.
Manages
to win
18.
This game, her Big Jiao. She just needs a little bit of this, doesn't she? Just to give her the encouragement to turn this match around.
Well, you just sense a little momentum shift. It probably won't be enough for her Big Jiao to take this first game.
18.
But it'll certainly give her some confidence heading into the second.
It's the first time in the match she's had any kind of rhythm. now some questions to be asked for
14, 18.
Kawakami for the first time. 4 points in a row, gap down to four.
Another error from Herbing Jiao, puts it back to five again.
That's a let off, isn't
19,
it, really?
14.
Just started to build up some momentum. Game points to Saena Kawakami, six of them.
20, game point, 14.
Almost.
Service over, 15, 20.
At the end of this game, hasn't there, for Herbing Jiao to
16,
feel that there is a way 20. Of still winning this title.
Yeah, she just seems to be finding a little bit more rhythm, not being wrong-footed as easily as she was earlier on in the set.
She's still facing four game points here. Saved a couple so far. That's wide. And well, a little bit of a surprise. 17-year-old Japanese star Saena Kawakami takes the opening game. And so convincingly, what a performance. 21-16. Well, we weren't expecting quite that opening set, were we?
It's a dream start, really, for Kawakami to come out play as she did. She was able to move Herbing Jiao to all four corners of the court and make sure she had to really cover from line to line. It really paid off for her.
Now the tough prospect is to maintain that level and see the job through, because whatever the game plan was, it's been well thought out and it's working so far.
Yeah, I think Herbing Jiao is far too good to be able to play the same way against the whole way through the match, so it'll be interesting to see how firstly Herbing Jiao responds and then Kawakami in turn to her changes.
Yeah, you can see a little bit of the emotion there, can't you, on Herbing Zhao's face. You know, she knows she's got to start performing to the level she knows she's capable of, because as well as Kawakami's played, and we've got to take nothing away from her, we know Herbing Jiao can play better.
Certainly do. Yeah, she's just a little bit frustrated that she's not quite being able to play at her best today so far, but that can always change.
There's time.
Plenty.
Well, what an opportunity for Saena Kawakami. Can she win her first senior title?
Second game, love all,
well, play. An opportunity beckons here for Saena Kawakami. World ranking, well, should we pay attention, of 610. She's certainly playing nothing like that. The qualifier taking the opening set here.
Much better signs than Herbing Jiao on that point.
Just
moving a little bit faster and in control for the entire rally.
Two.
flat-footed there.
Service over. One,
Kawakami.
Two.
Gets off the mark in this second game. That's better from her than Jiao.
Service over. 3-1.
Do you fancy a three-setter here?
Quite possibly.
Service over. 2-3.
Hurried is there, Kawakami. She's just playing as she was just a few weeks ago in junior tournaments. that's a stunner.
Yeah, that's more of the Herving Jiao we saw yesterday. More patient, content to work Kawakami around the back line and then create the opportunity for herself.
It's fair to say she's got the crowd support here as well. There's quite a big Chinese community, isn't there, in Auckland, and obviously a fair few of turnout here at the North Shore Event Centre. Yeah, they know as well that she's got a struggle on her hands here, so I'm trying to give her the encouragement.
Over. 3-4.
Yeah, the volume from the crowd has certainly increased in the last 5 to 10 minutes.
Gave a look there, Herbie Jazz, as she was convinced that was heading long, but obviously not the case.
Yeah, Kawakami's been extremely good at making sure the height on her lifts is exactly right. She's not giving Herbie Jiao any time at the back line to create the angles and dangerous attacks that she has. Isn't that perfect?
That was the big question. Could she maintain the level that she was showing in the first game? And the answer is quite positive so far, isn't it, for the Japanese girl? Well, I was saying about the same point of the game in the opening game. It's not yet crisis time for her, but it is now.
Yeah, it's still early days in the second, but she hasn't been able. She built a little bit of momentum in the first sort of 3 or 4 points, but Kawakami's wrestled it straight back again. It's a great lift.
And where is Kawakami's?
7-4.
Lifts and clears are perfect. Herbing Jiao's just that little bit off the mark, and that makes all the difference. The umpire here is just saying to her not to celebrate the point until the call's been made from the line judge that it is out.
Yeah.
Because you could influence the decision, that's the
problem. Yeah, that's the reasoning behind it, yeah. You can be deemed to be influencing the line judge if you celebrate before they call. Broken string. Oh, that's great control. Losing that rally is really going to hurt Herbing Jiao. Even with a broken string, Kawakami still able to keep it in play.
I mean, it's that kind of day for her at the moment, isn't it? Break a string. You probably tie one hand behind her back. She's just hitting the middle of the racket. What a game.
8-4
up.
4-4 play.
And as you can hear, a 4-point lead for Saena Kawakami.
too flat on that occasion from Kawakami.
Service
just allowed Herbingjar to intercept it.
Eight.
Put the cross-court smash in for a winner. She knows it too.
Frustrating, isn't it, for her being Jiao? She actually played very well during the majority of that round. He probably thought she played a couple of shots there which were going to open things up for her, but they just didn't open up.
Yeah, it's credit to Kawakami. Her shot quality has been sublime so far. She just hasn't allowed her being Jiao to do anything. And then when you do get half a chance like that, you feel like you have to put it on the floor, and then it sometimes can draw the error.
Again, she's done it again here, but she's still not really dominating the point. Kawakami's just got the answers at the moment. Commentator's curse, they call that.
Throws their arms up in frustration, but again, a brilliantly worked point. This makes Herbingjar move from the back line all the way to the front.
Nine.
Snatched it a little bit. It's nice to see a reaction like that. She's enjoying it, and so she should, you know. Here she is, Grand Prix Gold Final, and she's playing to the best of her ability up against an opponent whose reputation just speaks for itself, you know. Olympic youth, world, Asian medals, you know.
Yeah, so often in finals as well, often you see pairs that aren't able to pull out their best, but they just have to fight. But when you can play as well as Kawakami is, it's definitely a lot of fun. She's trying to play. She needs to get the height exactly right to get it over Herbingjar and keep it in the court as well. Just been a little bit flat in the last two occasions. Again, a well-played point, though, from Kawakami, just keeping Herbingjar on the back line, forcing her to try and create something from back there, which is very difficult to do. Came up with the error that time, but she's doing the right things.
Thank you. Play.
Fighting here hard, Herbingjar, to try and grab some kind of footing in this final. She has a game lead, but now she has an interval lead, Saena Kawakami here in this second game, 11-9.
Yeah, it hasn't been the turnaround that we thought Herbingjar would be able to come up with. early on in the second set. She hinted at it early, but Kawakami's just been too good.
Well, she's 10 points away now from a first senior title. 10 big points. Won't be easy to come, and they'll probably get harder, you would assume, the closer she gets to the to that finishing line.
But
just got to try somehow to maintain the standard she has set here in this final.
Yeah, what she's done so well is just hasn't given her Bing Zhao any opportunities to attack. An attack with danger, I guess.
11-9, play.
It's been so hard from being put right on the back line to really create anything that's going to hurt Kawakami. Again, perfectly executed.
Oh, that was tight.
And again, you see a little bit of impatience from Herbing Zhao, just trying to create the winner when
12,
maybe she shouldn't have.
9.
I think it's her pride that's hurting more than anything right now.
10.
I mean, you must have had it yourself, Oliver. You know, some days you step out and court, you see the shuttle perfectly. Others, your legs start moving just too slowly. They feel very heavy.
Yeah, especially when you come up against quality opposition that's not going to give you any chance to attack and really score your points. You have to work so hard for every chance, and then like Herbing Zhao does, sometimes goes for a little too early. Because she has to work so hard, she feels she has to do more when she does get that sometimes half chance.
There was another like that sign. She was trying to play the tightest of net shots, because she knows otherwise it's not going to be a winner.
Yeah, Kawakami's just going to lift it straight on the back line, and then she has to start her work all over again. Unable to create any sustained pressure.
This time it did go out. Celebration of relief. Oh, nothing there
11,
from Bing Zhao.
14.
Classy shots in this rally, wasn't it?
14. Fine.
Oh, did she mean to leave that, or she was trying to get to that?
I think credit to her, it was the last minute.
Service over.
Pulling out from hitting
15,
that shot.
12.
Right decision. 3-point lead, and now 6 points away from taking the New Zealand Open title. Jiao, they're trying to up the pace, but to no avail.
Absolutely, yeah. It's just it's clever from Kawakami. She's just not giving her Jiao the opportunities to be able to hit 3 or 4 dangerous shots in a row.
Right.
Every time she comes with pace, she'll take the pace out of it, move her Jiao to the other side. Give herself a chance to get back in the rally.
Just long. Yeah. It's always a surprise when she's not on the money.
Service over, 13-16.
Clearly out.
The cross court was coming.
Okay, we're coming. Pop up, please. 14-17.
She's feeling the pace a bit, you think?
Possibly. Maybe after she had a good tournament in China Masters, had a week off, and now is in the final here as well. Maybe it's just some fatigue coming in.
And she hasn't really been worked like this in any of those matches over the last few weeks.
No, and of course, when you have to take that extra step and all the time is being pushed and pushed and pushed, it does take its toll physically.
Just wide from Kawakami. When you're getting closer to achieving that ultimate goal.
Yeah, maybe she just tenses up just a fraction, and it's just enough to bring a few errors into her game.
Service
just didn't fall the right side of the net for her, being Zhao, and I think she's hurt. I think she's hurt herself a little bit there.
Service
made a great effort to retrieve 18, it.
Yeah, 17. It was some great retrieval from her in that rally. That one there.
Just in the middle. It's good to see that she's not seeing it, obviously, we're watching the replay, but she's back out on court now. Obviously still feeding it, but there's no, you know, delaying tactics or anything like that.
No, no. But she seems to be okay.
Trying to stay alive.
Service over, 18-18.
Asking for a towel down the players, but she saw the gap, exploited it.
Yeah, she seemed to find a way to be able to play those shots from an on-balance position now. Cutting out the mistakes that she was making with them earlier.
Clever, deceptive. Good time to do it as well.
Yeah, great time to come up with something different than Hibbing Jiao hasn't
19,
seen before.
18.
She probably has, but not from Kawakami today.
Of her being Zhao, it's match point.
20. Match point.
It's New 18. Zealand Open title points for Saena Kawakami. Obviously, some in the crowd didn't realize it must have touched her racket, but.
Yeah, you couldn't tell from Hibbing Jiao's reaction either.
Well, the umpire was convinced.
Length is so good.
It's good! It's good! And Saena Kawakami has just won the New Zealand Open. Her first victory at senior level. The qualifier, the 17-year-old from Japan, has come all the way through the tournament to take gold. What a performance.
Yeah, I mean, we were singing Hibbing Jiao's praises after yesterday's match and in the lead up to today's one, but that was unbelievably impressive from Kawakami. Just never gave Hibbing Jiao an opportunity to get in the match, and even when she did it when it was close at the end of the second, she was able to close it out.
Well, you have to say that's a bit of a surprise. 21-16, 21-18, Saena Kawakami, your champion. Well, she's gone from last time out semi-finals of the German juniors to winner of a Grand Prix gold title. That's quite a step up.
It's not bad for a first senior tournament.
First one outside of Japan, yeah. It's extraordinary the way the sport does that. You know, there was Hibbing Jiao winning the China Masters, straight games all the way through to the winning that title, straight games wins all the way through to the final here. But credit to Kawakami, she exploited all the weaknesses that were there, and she just played to her optimum level, really, didn't she?
Yeah, she played a fantastic game today, and the plan that she had, she executed pretty much perfectly. There was a couple of nervy moments at the end of the second. But,
ladies and gentlemen,
yeah, it was a really, really polished performance
for the women's singles final at the Skycity New Zealand Badminton Open. Your presenters, Julie Garlick, Skycity Marketing Manager, and Skycity VIP, Terry Eyre. runner-up in the women's singles. Please show your thoughts and appreciation for China's Hui Bing Zhao. And the winner of the women's singles final at the Skycity New Zealand Open from Japan, Saena Kawakami.
Performance from Kawakami. Let's see what she makes it of. She's going to be talking right now with Stephen again.
Smiles all around, Saena. Congratulations. How emotional is it to win your first senior title?
She's not feeling it. She just won the title. She can't get it just yet.
What was the game plan against your opponent? You seemed to want to run her around and take her power game away.
The作戦はどんな感じで、相手をね振り回した感じなんですけど、相手があの日本人とやってる試合を見て、カットがすごく上手い選手なので、ポジションを前にして、なるべくカットでやられない対策を。 Oh, it's a little bit complicated, but she has watched her matches, you know, in the past and how she was playing. So she was trying to get to forward and trying to not cut the fair shots before she hits the back.
It's been a dream week for you as a qualifier. Can we see you back here next year?
来年来る予定ありますか? すごく今年良かったので、来年来る予定。また来年も優勝したい。 She wants to come back and win.
We'll have you back. Congratulations.
Thank you.
That could well be the biggest smile of the day, couldn't it? She is one happy young lady. Good to see her enjoying a special moment. Yeah, it really was for her. And she'd obviously worked it out tactically. She said she had been watching her Bing Zhao. But it's the hard thing is in a final like this to... and play to the plan.
Yeah, exactly. It's one thing to know or have a plan in place that you want to do, but another thing to execute it, especially in a final and a first Grand Prix gold final for someone who's 17 years old. It was impressive, that, again, the maturity she showed and the execution that she was able to achieve.
Yeah, 21-16, the first game, and then, you know, could she see it through? You know, could she maintain that level? And the answer obviously was, yeah, she could.
Yeah, I think maybe that's one area that Hui Bing Zhao can improve on, to try and come up with a different game or a solution when she gets pushed around on the back line and her attacking shots get taken out of the equation like it was today.
Oh, she won't forget New Zealand in a hurry, will she? Saena Kawakami. Look at that. She's victorious. Japan has gold. And of course, next up, a really interesting men's singles affair.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a special presentation now being made in our presentation area. Representing the Badminton World Federation, would you please acknowledge and welcome Vivian Mahalingam as he makes a presentation to Devin Smith, President of Badminton New Zealand, to acknowledge the hosting of this gold status Grand Prix tournament.
Thank you.